Creating a task list for employees in Excel can help you help your employees focus on completing their key tasks. You'll first want to create a master list of all the tasks that you need for your employees to complete. And you can do something like what I have here. So it should include the employee's name, position titles, and departments. And this is especially helpful if your employees move to different roles and then you need to send the task list to a new associate. You may also want to include any due date and, of course, any additional fields that your specific business may need. Make sure to format your data as a table. Doing this will make it so that any new information you add to this will automatically be captured into your table range. And also later, we'll be using formulas and it'll make it easier if we can reference the table name. So you can do this either by pressing Ctrl T on your keyboard or by selecting it from the Home tab in your ribbon. So if you're watching this tutorial, you'll likely have a small business with employees. And if so, you should try the sponsor of this video, Connecteam. So Connecteam is a super easy to use app that employees can use right on their mobile phones. And Connecteam will really help streamline how you assign tasks to your employees. So you can create and assign tasks to your employees in just a couple of clicks. So by including detailed descriptions, subtasks, attachments, due dates, and more, you and your team will always be on the same page regarding communications about each task. There's even a comment section for task-related communications. You can get real-time updates on task completion, so no more chasing your team. You can check in with your employees to request status updates and send push reminders because, let's face it, we all forget things from time to time. You'll have clear visibility on all ongoing tasks. You can navigate and organize tasks with tags and advanced filtering capabilities, view tasks by completion status, and more. So easily create and manage recurring tasks, checklists, and forms right from your phone. So whether you manage a team with different shifts in one location or out on the field, this will be such a time saver for everyone involved. Plus, if you have 10 users or less, it's free to use. And thank you, Connecteam, for sponsoring this video and supporting this channel. One quick way to create your employee task list, regardless of your version of Excel, is to create a pivot table of the tasks for each employee. So go to the Insert tab in your ribbon, click on Pivot Table, and we want to select this range with all of the task lists, which we have done here. For this example, I'm going to do this on a new worksheet. So we'll click OK. And let's expand the field list. We'll filter by employee name at the top. Then I want to list in the row the tasks followed by the due date. And we'll come back up to our ribbon. And anytime that you're in a pivot table, you're going to get special pivot table tabs. So we'll click on the design tab. And we'll go to Report Layout, and we'll select Show in Tabular Form. You also want to get rid of where it says Do Not Show Any Subtotals. And we also don't need a grand total because this is a list of tasks, not anything we're quantifying. And then let's filter this for employee Jamie. And we can see her task list for the week. And lastly, let's not forget to label the tab with the employee's name. So one drawback with using a pivot table for this is that your employees can see tasks assigned to other employees just by coming up here and revising which employee the task list is filtered by. So this may or may not be a problem in your business, but I know in the past, I've worked on a few projects before they were ready to be shared with others. So as with anything business related, it just depends on your specific organization and its needs. So this next method that we're going to walk through is my favorite. However, much of the functionality is only available to users of Excel 365. So let's insert a new tab for this next example, and we'll start by labeling it Jamie Tasks. And here in cell A1, we'll label the document. And you can do it manually. You can type Jamie Task List into the cell, or like I'm doing here, you can create a formula to reference the tab name. And before I go on, it's important to know that this formula will not work on Excel Mobile or on Excel on the web or other versions of Excel other than Excel 365. So if any of those apply to you, just write the name manually. Otherwise, it will cause an error on your sheet. So with that said, we're going to use the text after function, open parentheses. Within that, we'll nest the cell function, close the parentheses. And then from this list, we're going to select file name, comma, and we'll enter the location of the cell, which is A1, close that parentheses, comma, quotation mark, and within that quotation mark, we'll use the open bracket delimiter, close the quotation mark, now close the parentheses, and press enter. And I'm also going to bold this. Now we'll skip a line just so that it's a bit easier on the eye. And then we'll create labels here for employee name, department, and let's add colons to these, and position. We will also bold these and expand the cells. So to get the employee name, I'm going to use a formula that uses a combination of the left and search functions to extract the employee name from the text that's in cell A1. And in this example, this will look like equals left. We open parentheses and we want to get the text from cell A1, comma, and then for the number of characters, this is where we'll use the search function. So type search. We'll put quotation mark, blank space, and quotation mark. And this means that Excel will now search for the blank space, which in this example will be the blank space between Jamie and the word tasks, comma, within the text in cell A1, close the parentheses, and we'll say minus 1 because we don't want to count the space as a character when we return the characters to the left of that space. So we'll close the parentheses and press enter. So to get the employee's department, I'm going to use an XLOOKUP. So we'll write equals XLOOKUP and we'll select the employee name as the lookup value, comma, and back in the master list of employee tasks, of company tasks, we'll select the employee name column as the lookup array, press comma, and we want to return the department name. So we'll select this as the return array and then press enter. And we'll do the same thing. Use XLOOKUP to look up the employee's position. So again, we select Jamie as the lookup value, the employee name as our lookup array, and then we want to return Jamie's positions. We'll select the positions column for that and press enter. So next, below this, in row 7, I'm going to add headers for 4 items, which will be tasks, due date, completed, and we'll write yes or no in parentheses, and comment. And let's expand these to fit, and let's bold these. So to pull all of the tasks for employee Jamie, I'm going to use the filter function. So under task, I'll write equals filter. We'll go to the master list of tasks again. And for the array, I want to select the task column, comma, and then it should include, and this is what we'll filter by, we'll select the employee name column, and then that should equal cell B3 where we've listed the employee name, comma again, and if empty, I just want to leave the field blank, so we'll type quotation marks, a space, quotation marks, and then we'll close the parentheses and press enter, and this pulls all of Jamie's tasks. And we'll do the same thing with the due date. We'll use the filter function again, so we'll type equals filter. The array this time will be the due date, comma, and we want to include it if the employee name equals to what's in cell B3, Jamie, and if there's no value to return, We'll again use a blank space for that. We'll close the parentheses and pull the results. Now, one thing to be aware here, this will continually update anytime the master list updates. So if you don't want that to happen, you can either create a version of this task list by week. So for example, you could save this file as task list for March week 1, 2024, and so on, so you're not altering past lists. Or you could copy these and then paste as values. That'll erase the formulas and hard code the results. But I'm going to undo that because I want to keep the formulas in there. So for the completed yes, no, we're going to create a data validation list. So since we know exactly how many tasks we have, I'm just going to select that many cells. Under the Data tab in Data Tools, look for Data Validation and click on that. Under Allow, I want to create a list. And the source, so somewhere in your sheet, you want to write just the options, yes or no. And in the master list of employee tasks, I've already done that kind of here to the side. So we'll just select yes and no, those two cells, and click OK. And now your employees can say, I've completed it or I haven't completed the task. And the comments, of course, just be handwritten comments done manually. Let's delete this. Now, earlier, I made the comment that this was my favorite way of doing the task list. And the reason for that is all of these formulas we created makes it super easy to do a task list for your other employees once you have the one. So coming down to the tab that says Jamie Tasks, you can go to Move or Copy. We'll create a copy. And let's say we want to do Emerson's tasks. We can change the name Jamie to Emerson. We'll delete the two at the end of that. And now the list automatically updates with Emerson's data. So thanks for watching. And for more tutorials like this, please click on these links. Thanks.